decade of the last century was marked by war and the consolidation of a globalized market economy, enforced by the growing power of international financial institutions and militarized superpower nations. As the impact of unfair trade agreements, war, suppression of human rights reverberated through the ranks of the poor and marginalized in both North and South, people's protest movements all over the world took to the streets. By 2001, a powerful confluence of social movements and people's protests had come together within the framework of the World Social Forum. Many feminists, equally outraged by the flagrant violation of human rights and justice, joined in these protest movements and actively sought to create alliances. During the same period, feminists who had invested in global advocacy strategies were seeking to collectively take stock of their gains as a feminist movement. It was in this layered context that the Feminist Dialogues was first conceived.
Started, I think, in a lot of different places at the same time, more or less. Many of the women who had been a part of the feminist movement were kind of feeling a sense of losing ground and losing space, I think, in the 1990s, late 1990s and now, from the year 2000 onwards.
El Foro Social Mundial tiene esta confluencia de movimientos sociales, redes, instituciones. Los diálogos feministas surgieron en el marco del Foro Social Mundial y nos dejaron, y el foro nos deja una cantidad de conexiones y de aprendizajes. Es un proceso, como ustedes seguramente van a percibirlo, ya lo han percibido, interesante, apasionante, pero también contradictorio. Esta idea de las alianzas y las disputas con otros movimientos está absolutamente presente también dentro del foro, porque por supuesto que hay resistencia de los movimientos sociales a las propuestas feministas.
A handful of vocal feminists participated in the International Committee of the World Social Forum and actively lobbied for the inclusion of feminist perspectives and for the democratization of the World Social Forum process.
Estamos allí para garantizar la expresión, la generación de un espacio democrático que son los foros, que no excluya a ninguna diversidad, que no excluya ninguna voz, que no excluya a ningún actor o actora. Esa es nuestra única función y esa función nos parece que es una función altamente política.
The change that was also brought in terms of the earlier emphasis of the World Social Forum, which was predominantly on neoliberal globalization, was to really bring it, when it came to India, one thing we very clearly put it not only as neoliberal globalization, but as imperialist globalization. We added the whole issue of fundamentalism.
Even so, feminists from both North and South participating in the Third World Social Forum in Porto Alegre in January 2003 felt that they had limited impact in that space. They gathered on several occasions during the World Social Forum to strategize for a greater feminist presence and perspective in the process. In one such small gathering held on a grassy patch under a tree, called for by Latin American feminists, the idea of holding a transnational feminist meeting just prior to the World Social Forum was discussed. The meeting under the tree, as it is now referred to, was one of the catalytic moments for the feminist dialogues. Similar discussions took place during the same period in India, Latin America, and New York, where feminists met and the momentum soon gathered. Over a quick few months of consultation by electronic mail, a coordinating group consisting of seven international organizations and networks was formed. The group went immediately to work on organizing the first feminist dialogues just prior to the World Social Forum in Mumbai, India, ironing out ideological differences and establishing core values of organizing, even as it made logistical and political preparations for the meeting. The first feminist dialogues was held in Mumbai, India in January 2004 and attended by 150 women from different regions of the world.
We started it in Bombay and we had a lot of teething problems working along with the other members of the network because we didn't know each other, so it was just sort of finding out how you could work with them. So a lot of problems along with that, but we worked all that out. Then we had the feminist dialogues in Bombay. Part of it was very good. Like the younger feminists who came, especially from different parts of the country and from the world. Very delighted to see some of the older ones they'd heard about or read about, hear what they had to say, meet up with each other.
Despite the hitches and glitches, the coordinating group felt that the first feminist dialogues had provided a democratic space for taking stock of diverse viewpoints and perspectives to emerge, and that this process should continue. Drawing on the lessons of the past experience, a second feminist dialogues was thus organized just prior to the Fifth World Social Forum in Porto Alegre in January 2005. Feminists came from places as far-flung as Suriname and Macedonia, Tanzania and Tonga. Over 250 younger and older feminists, women working on many different issues, both within the women's movements and within other social justice movements, came with great enthusiasm and energy, bound together with many common political concerns and eager to explore their diversities.
I'm expecting a continuation of the conversation that started at the Feminist Dialogues last year in Mumbai. I'm expecting to see people that I haven't seen in a while and reconnect with them.
I think it's so easy to get caught up in what you're doing and try and do your work in isolation, but as feminists we can't, because we have to look up and see how we're affected by society.
Because the question we tried to ask ourselves was, why is it that the women's movement in Malaysia isn't growing as fast or as big as we would like it to? And one of the things we realized was that we haven't really managed to encourage younger women to be part of the movement.
I hope that we can learn from each other, that we can inform each other, so we can strengthen ourselves to do better work in our organization.
My expectation here is to see where women are at in terms of the issues, you know, in the whole world about women, and to say how these issues are dealt with today.
In my context, this meeting is very important to understand better what is the interpretation of the word feminist.
We do not necessarily need answers for everything, but I think we need to take them to another level and bring in new perspectives.
I think we are in this space, the feminist dialogue, really to talk about how to strengthen our movements, how to repoliticize our movements.
The second feminist dialogues in Porto Alegre improved from the experience of the first meeting in Mumbai. This meeting was structured to allow space for groups to explore the feminist movement and its political strategies in resisting neoliberal globalization, fundamentalisms, and militarism within the context of the body.
In this dialogue in itself,
a background note was said to provoke discussions around several key questions in workshop groups. However, the outcome of the meeting was left open-ended. The organizers wanted for both points of resonance as well as points of difference and divergence to emerge without forcing any particular unity of thought or unity of action. The energy levels in the workshop groups were invariably high as participants readily shared their insights and strategies on the themes of the meeting. Although the feminist dialogues did not seek to come up with unified positions or perspectives, there was a deep resonance amongst the participants on the need for a stronger articulation of a feminist politics of resistance.
Eu acho que o feminismo pode contribuir com uma ideia de revolução, até porque o feminismo sempre colocou a questão da revolução como um processo de transformação cultural, material, mas sempre defendeu a não violência como no processo revolucionário.
Que ao grupo em geral le preocupa a aparição, entre comillas, de este nuevo calificativo del movimiento feminista transnacional, principalmente porque se trata de un concepto cargado de significados, un término que, como todas sabemos, se aplica a capitales financieros y no a los movimientos.
I really hope people will think about this year as a time to defend the proactive gains women made in the Beijing platform and use that review as a moment to get attention, to make sure women's voices are there.
And I think that there lies the bridging of movements, of the bridging of different feminisms. What do women at the local level, daily living so many constraints and challenges, are saying? And how can we, from the international level, go to the field and meet with them and see how we can link?
Creo que uno de los dilemas que enfrentamos o de los desafíos que tenemos en este nuevo siglo, a inicio de este nuevo siglo, es cómo lograr asentar, desarrollar la propuesta feminista como una propuesta política.
Por un lado, esta necesidad de redefinir el feminismo como proyecto político en su capacidad subversiva, la necesidad de retomar la capacidad subversiva del feminismo y su potencial de reconstruir utopías.
As alianças, também discutimos que as alianças se estabelecem entre sujeitos políticos autônomos e independentes. São alianças a partir das quais o feminismo pode radicalizar a agenda do outro, dos outros movimentos com os quais estabelece aliança. Mas, ao mesmo tempo, o movimento feminista é influenciado e transformado por essa agenda.
Our very activism in all its different forms is a site of resistance. Likewise, recognizing the different avenues, particularly, for example, in education, such as by initiative like Women's Studies, where we formulate new standards and new paradigms, that's another side of resistance.
For once, can we be proactive?
There were strong and interesting debates and proposals put forward as participants advocated their own passionate perspectives and struggles.
Nosotras en América Latina estamos luchando fuertemente por el aborto. Creo que ha habido un cambio radical en este último periodo que me parece muy importante desde una mirada más institucionalizada durante un largo periodo en los 90 hacia una mirada que trata de recuperar la subversión político-cultural que para mí en este momento está expresada en muchas cosas, pero básicamente en la lucha por el aborto y en la lucha por el reconocimiento de la diversidad sexual, ¿no?
Can you have men who are feminists? Some would say no, some would argue that no, by the mere term, you're just talking women. But others would say that, or would argue that there are men who will definitely champion the issues of women and would support all the issues that are articulated by feminists and would therefore be entitled to be called feminists.
Sí, vimos que mucho había todavía por ver hacia nosotras mismas, ser realmente inclusivas, desaprender muchas de las cosas que hemos aprendido, sí, que en temas de discriminación, o sea, desaprender un montón de prácticas que son discriminatorias para poder aprender nuevas formas de relacionarnos.
Una tiene que ver con las alianzas intergeneracionales que implican también estrategias más fuertes, más contundentes de autocuidado y cuidado colectivo de las compañeras que conformamos el movimiento. Y un último punto que en lo personal me parece muy importante, que es el fortalecimiento de las organizaciones de mujeres jóvenes.
One of the most exciting areas of, you know, in terms of resistance and which is leading to a lot of dialogue is the whole issue of sexual rights, because within that comes up a whole set of issues which I think as feminists we have engaged with, but have engaged with it in terms of usually violence or in terms of disease control, but very rarely in the context of rights of women, also the whole issue of pleasure.
Entonces yo las invito a que empecemos a mirarnos de otra manera, a que no sigamos repitiendo el fundamentalismo de los idiomas que solo nombra una cosa y de una determinada manera como ha sido construida. Si de algo me siento orgullosa, de ser parte de esa deconstrucción que declamó durante años el feminismo. Yo soy parte. Y tomo el feminismo no como una proclama, sino como la práctica cotidiana que me ayudó a deconstruir la masculinidad con la que había sido socializada los primeros años de mi vida.
C'est que l'intégrisme actuellement a changé de stratégie, il a changé de moyen de travail. Et il a changé de conception des choses. Et il a poussé même les partis de gauche à l'échelle internationale à coopérer avec lui.
In our countries, in Muslim countries, fundamentalists seek political power directly. They aim at promoting a theocracy. And they are a political movement of a fascist nature.
Quisiera que no nos fuéramos de acá sin señalar otro fundamentalismo que está campeando en una parte igualmente extendida del planeta, que es el de la Iglesia Católica.
When we look at how fundamentalisms have risen, the reason why it is one of our themes in this discussion, whereas it was not for some years, is because we see that they have successfully used the practice of democracy, the language of human rights, and the language of diversity to gain legitimacy, visibility, and ascendancy as some sort of legitimate social movements.
I come from the Great Lakes region in Burundi. And our region has been in a war. If it is not in Rwanda, it is in Burundi. If it is not in Burundi, it is in DRC. So I think it is our obligation, let's say our duty, to denounce this kind of trafficking arms of, which are doing harm in our countries.
Whether you are at peace in your own country or not, you are still affected by war. So we are all at war in one way or another. We have refugees coming in. We have women being raped right and left and center by, you know, soldiers and so on. We are at war as women.
How can feminists support women living under occupation? Should we support the resistance in Iraq, whatever that means, in whatever form?
I'm Naba from Iraq, and I want to go back to Iraq issue to make some points more clearer. The question raised about whom to support and how to support Iraqi women. Iraqi women now between two shocks. The first one, the US military, and the second shock is the terrorism and the fundamentalism. The terrorism and the fundamentalism, they used religion as the rope to cover their themselves.
En todos nuestros países se está precisamente negociando un TLC, el ALCA. Se está viendo todo un plan Puebla-Panamá donde la soberanía de nuestros países está en riesgo, donde todos los recursos naturales están en riesgo, donde realmente se nos está viendo como poblaciones en donde nos vamos a involucrar en las maquilas que ya están instaladas en nuestros países, en todos nuestros países, en condiciones nefastas, y sobre todo para las mujeres y para las mujeres jóvenes.
We must continue to find ways on how to confront each other in a respectable way and within safe spaces, on how we are bringing economic justice or the need for redistribution of wealth and opportunities into our feminist analytic and political equation.
There isn't just one form, and we have got to think politically about what kind of market-based accumulation model we want to live with. We could say we don't want any of them, but the burden is then to produce an alternative.
Several participants expressed their desire to continue this process of dialogue and political articulation at regional or national levels. A third Feminist Dialogues will be hosted by African feminists in 2007, building upon the gains and lessons learned from the previous two events. With the wellspring of enthusiasm and insight from participants and organizers alike, this next meeting promises to further deepen the dialogue on feminist analysis and strategies for resistance.
What we do hope is that we do have another feminist dialogue in Africa in 2007. And we do also hope that all of you who have been part of this FD and also others who you think would be interested in the next FD would also contribute to a thought process, to the planning, to the preparation.
Pero seguimos apostando a los diálogos feministas, a los diálogos como espacio de encuentro de feministas de distintas partes del mundo. Diálogos para darle rostro a las acciones que hacemos todas nosotras todos los días en cualquier parte. Diálogos para explicitar las estrategias desde las cuales estamos resistiendo al fundamentalismo, al militarismo, al neoliberalismo. Diálogo pese a las fronteras, con el límite que tuvimos incluso al dibujar los grupos.
Great deal of concern.